Hey guys, in this video, I want to go over several Python solutions for the reverse integer problem on LeetCode. There are several ways to complete this problem, and they range from simple to more complicated solutions. I also hope you can learn some Python-specific language features along the way. The problem statement is pretty straightforward. We simply want to reverse the digits of an integer. So for instance, 123 will become 321. Keep in mind that the solution should also work on negative values. And additionally, we do need to watch out for the size constraint specified here as well. So the first solution is what I would consider as the most simple and Pythonic method. We want to use the fact that converting an integer to a string and vice versa is very simple in Python. Reversing a string in Python is also very easy and concise. The basic idea is to first convert the integer into a string, next reverse the string, and finally convert the reverse string back into an integer and return the result. Alright, so this is the coded solution. Let's walk through some of the things we need to watch out for beyond the basic steps. First, when we convert the integer into a string, we need to keep in mind that the minus sign in front of negative integers will also be contained in the string. This means that when we reverse the string, the minus sign will be placed after the reversed digits. This will raise an error when we try to convert it back into an integer. In order to solve this problem, we want to get rid of the minus sign by taking the absolute value of the integer. However, we need some way to preserve whether the number was positive or negative. Here, we decided to declare a variable called sign, which stores positive or negative 1 depending on the original integer. We can then multiply this to the result at the end to make sure it comes out correctly. Note that this one-line notation is called a conditional expression, or Python's shorthand way of writing conditional statements. This is similar to a ternary operator in other languages and can help make your code more concise when the conditions are simple. Now in the next step, we're using Python's extended slice notation to reverse the string. This is the most Pythonic and concise way to reverse a string or any iterator type in Python. Keep in mind that this does not modify the original elements since it makes a new reverse string or iterator. We then convert the string back into an integer in the same line, since this is a simple operation. Finally, we need to check that the result falls within the specified range. In Python, we can check whether a number falls between a certain range by combining what would normally be two separate Boolean expressions. This is just like how we would express it in a more mathematical notation. Of course, we will then return the result if the condition checks out. Otherwise, we return 0. Let's go through the time and space complexity analysis now. Converting integer to string, reversing a string, and converting string back into an integer all takes O of n, or linear time. Here, n is defined as the number of digits in the integer x. Hence, the overall time complexity is O of n linear time. Sometimes, solutions will state that this has a O of log n time. This is correct, but only if you define n as the integer input x itself, since log base 10 of an integer roughly equals the number of digits it has. As for the space complexity, since we're storing the string version of the number here, the space taken is proportional to the number of digits in x. Hence, the space complexity is also O of n, where n is the number of digits in x. Alright, now let's run the code and check if it works. Now the second solution is a more standard approach to this problem. This method behaves like a stack and improves the time and space complexity of the first solution. We want to build the reversed integer one digit at a time using simple numerical operations. So the basic idea is, first, extract the rightmost digit of x. Second, get rid of the extracted digit and update x. Third, push the digit onto the result. and finally return the result when x becomes 0. Alright, let's walk through the coded solution now. Again, we want to take the absolute value of the input integer. However, this time the reason for this is to avoid unnecessary complications in the while loop. In Python, the modulus operator and the integer division operator for negative numbers will not work as expected and will need to be taken care of separately. I'll talk more about this in the next solution. By forcing the number to be positive, we can avoid all these cases. Hence, we will store the sign of the original integer in a variable like before. In the while loop, we want to take the rightmost digit and essentially append it to the result for every iteration until there are no more digits. Number mod 10 will give us the rightmost digit. We then need to update the number to reflect taking away this digit by dividing it by 10 using integer division. And finally, in order to make space for the digit, we need to push the digits in the current result to the left by multiplying 10 to the result. Then we simply use addition to append the digit to this new result. And like in the first solution, we restore the sign of the number and check if the result is within the specified range. Now let's talk about time and space complexity. The time complexity is O of n like before, where n is the number of digits in the input integer. However, this time, we're only iterating through each of the digit exactly once. In the first solution, converting integer to and from a string, as well as reversing the string, all took n iterations each, which means that more work had to be done. Now the space complexity for this solution is O of 1, or constant space, since we are only storing a few integer values. Alright, let's run the solution and see if it works. Finally, let's take a look at the third and more complicated solution. This solution aims to accurately address the range constraint specified in the problem. If we're working in a system that is actually constrained by this integer range, then we have to make sure that we do not fall out of this range at any point in the function, not just when we return it. In the previous solutions, we ignore this fact and only check the condition at the very end. This is because, unlike languages such as Java or C++, the max and min range of an integer in Python is essentially infinite. The integer size is only constrained by the amount of memory available. However, if the system we're executing this function in is strictly constrained, then our previous solutions will be incorrect, since at any point during the function, we could have built a result that overflowed that range. In order to fix this, we need to do the conditional checks inside the while loop. We need to make sure that we return out of the function immediately if the result overflows when we append the next digit. This means that we also need to take care of negative values separately instead of tossing them into the absolute value function. So, the basic idea is similar to the previous solution, except that we need to check the conditions in between. So, for the third step, we need to check if pushing the digit will result in an overflow. Alright, so here is the coded solution. This time, we only need to keep a result variable. The sign variable is not needed since we're working with negative values directly. As mentioned before, the modulus and integer division operators act strangely when dealing with negative values. In order to give the correct result for the modulus operation on negative values, we need the value on the right-hand side of the operator to also be negative. As for the integer division, we need to be using floating point division first, and then cast it into an integer. This will truncate negative and positive values as expected. You can experiment with these odd behaviors yourself in the Python interpreter to get a sense of why we had to do this. Now let's check for overflow. If the current result is greater than the max int divided by 10, then we know for sure that in the next step, when we multiply the result by 10, an overflow will happen. For example, if the max int is 128 and our current result is 13, then 13 times 10 will be 130, which is greater than the maximum int. We can check this prior to the multiplication step by comparing 13 with 12, which is what 128 integer divided by 10 is. Continuing with our example, what if our current result was 12? Well, if our current result equals the max int divided by 10, then we need to check if the digit that we're trying to append is greater than the last digit of the maximum int. Let's say our digit that we extracted is 9, and our current result is 12. Then if we do res times 10 plus digit, we would get 129, which is greater than the max int. This is why we need to do these two separate Boolean checks. Now the check for overflowing negative values is very similar, so I won't go over this in detail. If the conditional checks fail, then we immediately return 0 since we know the result will overflow. Otherwise, we can safely append the new digit onto the result. We don't have to do a check at the very end like before, since all the rigorous checks have already been done in the while loop. Now the time complexity is still O of n, and the space complexity is still O of 1 like before. Alright, let's run through the solution and check if it works. Awesome! So yeah, these are three different solutions for the reverse integer problem on LeetCode. I hope you learned something along the way. Please feel free to let me know if you're at all confused with anything in the comments down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed. Thanks!